Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nitcher, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. The subject of religion is very easy if you have interest in it. And people who have not studied theology, they are new skins, like that born blind person of John 9, who did not go to any school or anything, but he grew up blind to his age. That means maybe 25 or more, you know, he was when Jesus opened his eyes. So people who get drunk with the old wine of the letters from their childhood onward, you know, keep on reading scriptures. Scriptures are letters, and gospel is hidden in them, but unless you have the Spirit of God, you cannot discern it, or you cannot bring it up. So this is called Holy Spirit. The Spirit is planted by our Father in your heart, and it's up to you to use that sensible spirit for the benefit of humanity. Then it is called holy. But if you use it to destroy humanity, like making atomic bombs, cheating, fleecing people, making the life of others miserable, then it's called evil spirit. So choice is yours. But He has given you the Spirit, with which you can see the Father in spirit. This is natural Father, you know, everyone. But these days, even this Father, they have forgotten, you know. And never mind spiritual Father. So this is the tribal Father. All this land on this earth belonged to Adam and his sons. And if you have a tribal instinct in you, then the land will be known after your tribe. As this house I'm sitting here belongs to me, is a Niger. So same way, you know, if when the tribe occupy the village or country, you know, then the country is known after their tribe, like Afghanistan, Balochistan, Uzbekistan, all that in the east, you know, all are based upon their tribal, and so are in the west, Germany for Germans, and England for English, Scot for Scottish, so Ireland for Irish people, and not for Catholic and Protestant, you know, they are spiritual self. But this is a dark age. Dark age means people even don't know their tribal father or these simple things. And so they are just, you know, moving around haphazardly without anything, you know. So then the people who try to dominate are those who are psychic. Psychic are those who misuse the Spirit of God. And they will speak things from their mouth which are sugar-coated. And they won't speak anything that hurts people. You can see if a politician speaks something which is the people don't like it. And they will throw him out, because next time he won't get votes. He will be out, his party will be all gone, you know. All these political parties should be based on tribal basis, because they are the ones who are responsible for the country, not Labour, Conservative, Communist, Socialist, Green Party. What they have to do with the land? Land doesn't belong to them. Land belongs to England, belongs to English people. Scotland to Scottish people, Afghanistan to Afghan people. So they are the one who are concerned, not Muslim, Christian or Jew. Same the other way. Now God, because of this dark age, God has planted an ideal people in the Middle East, which we call them chosen people. And they have been given a promised land. So through them, people can learn, they can watch them and learn moral lessons, moral applied to here. So if you are morally sound, then spiritually sound, that you have sensible enough to sort out your moral issues, then you can understand spiritual things as well. So Abraham left his kith and kin as Melchizedek did. But Melchizedek, he was not married. He was solitary. In God, you have to be solitary when you worship God. Whereas Abraham, he was righteous person, everything same as Melchizedek, but he was married. He was a secular man. He was not purely spiritual. So that's why Abraham gave tithe to Melchizedek and accepted him as his spiritual guide. We call them sadhus. Melchizedek was a sadhu. So sadhus, they are devoted to God. They are not concerned with material things. So through these chosen people, God has taught us, you know, there's a, the all that you see with two naked eye, it belongs to the creator of male and female, and that one is Yahweh, not our God, which is spirit, which is inside me. This is of Yahweh. That's why the name Jesus is from Yeshua. Yeah, from Yahweh, Shua means Adam, the firstborn of Adam. Sorry, firstborn of Yahweh, second Adam. And being second Adam, he could not wanted to fight with the first Adam or set up a separate lineage in the name of second Adam. So he came like a floating with no rest, no place to rest his head. Remember, the foxes are fold, but Jesus had no place to rest his head. He had no secular property. He did not get married or no children. All these books they are writing, they are just exploiting the simple-minded people who become curious and they buy the book. And the man who wrote the book has made money. Is for the sake of mammon, they are writing all these stories. But those who are pneumatic, or those who are spiritual people, understand spiritual thing, they know that they are crook. But the spiritual people are 1 in 1,000 and 2 in 10,000, very little. Because most people, they like to be praised by the men. Like the dog collar people, they have been ordained by men, so their praises lie with men. Whereas those who are spiritual, they are ordained by our Father, God. This is the temple of God. He is inside us. When you speak truth and you are not a hypocrite, then you are worshipping God. Then only you can speak this gospel truth. But these politicians, they hardly speak the truth. If they do speak the truth, then what is inside them is not the same as outside. They are not like little children. They are grown-up crooks. And same with the Dakolo people, priest. They are working there as a secular job, taking money, like Judas Iscariot putting his hand in the purse to steal the money. And same with the Dakolo people, at the end of the month, they steal money from the church purse as their salaries. Salaries in Mammon. Our Father God pays in by grace in his own currency, which are gospel treasures. So if you want gospel treasures, then you don't take money. Then you will love God and God will give you the treasures. And then you can speak from your mouth as a free man. You are not slave to those your mammon masters. So that is why these royal priests of our Father, they are solitary. And although they are solitary, they are of one accord. As Jesus demonstrated in his 12 laborers. When he feed the 5,000, and they left him, because when he spoke the gospel truth, unless you eat the flesh of Jesus and drink the blood of Christ, you have no part in me. Now, they are literal meaning. They took literal meaning that he said, "No, cut me into small pieces and eat me." That is not what he meant. Spiritual meanings are that what came out of the mouth of Jesus, you should eat it with your ears. After eating it, take it to your heart and bring it from your mouth. That is called drinking the blood of Christ. I give you an example. Christ Paul, he said, a Jew is one who is a spiritual self inwardly, not the outwardly physical self. Now, hardly any one of you know that not a single Jew died during the Holocaust, because the physical self was born, physical self died. Now these politicians, you know, if they speak this simple gospel truth that not a single Jew died during the Holocaust, you will see the uproar in the church or in the political circle, and they will throw him out. So, this is the age in which people love darkness. And when they love darkness, then they suffer. And when they suffer, then they make hue and cry. In 1984, in India, this fanatic, Bindranwala, he did many wrong things, took weapons into the holiest of holy, which was not allowed, and he got so many people killed Gandhi was killed. So it created such a killing. So the falsehoods are spoken on communal basis, and people die on communal basis. Like in Holocaust, people died in millions because they became Jew outwardly on communal basis. Say when Christ Jesus was born, most of these people of Judah tribe, especially, they were Jew outwardly, because Judah to Judaism, Judaism to Jew. That's how they became totally, 100% normally Jew outwardly. And very few remnant were still of Judah tribe. And for them, Jew was inwardly spiritual self. Those the one Jesus picked up. They are called the remnant. So not many people are there who are predestined by our Father. So those Judas Iscariot, he misused the spirit of our Father, God, and he became a thief, stealing from the purse. So such people who love mammon, not God, they are not allowed into the royal kingdom of God. So be careful of these politicians, these dog-collared hypocrites, and others, and be solitary and preach gospel to make other people solitary. That's why his word is called a double-edged sword. When you preach gospel, then you know why people are suffering and you know what is the cure. My father had this basic knowledge. So during the 1947 partition, I was 15 years old. And so my father told the village people, you know, in towns, that Sikh is a spiritual self, inwardly, not physical self. Never born, never die. So is Muslim and Hindu. They are spiritual selves. So don't fight with each other, because they are not the one who are going to die, but your tribal selves. So 2,000 people came to attack our village, and when they sent for my uncle to come and explain something, so my father went along with him, and the headman told that, oh, you have collected people to attack us. He said, no, we are not attacking. They have come to defend us, you know, to help us in case we have got being attacked. And when my father explained to him that Sikh and Muslim, they are spiritual self. They are never born, never die. So don't blacken your face by killing people in the name of Muslim and Sikh. And you have to give your own account to Allah. So when he understood it, and he told us, we have no enmity between our Jat tribe and the Arai tribe. No enmity between our tribe, we are friends. And he understood it, what mischief those three crooks have made. Gandhi was one of those crooks, have made selfish people under the hypocrisy of the British. Then he told my father, let's go to capital Lahore to stop this partition of the Punjab. My father said, it's too late. And he told his 2,000 people to look after us as their guest. And that is the power of a gospel. Same power, if used in Northern Ireland, it will create love between the people. They are people of Scottish and Irish origin. Scottish, they are settlers there, colonialist. But if they explain this gospel truth, they can live in peace. Otherwise, this grudge will carry on. Because when we become the sons of the Most High Father, then our love between our people is greater than our arrow's love, which is between our relations. As I demonstrated that 2,000 came to attack us, and when we gave the gospel truth, then we created love, which is called agape. Agape means divine love, that we have one Father and we are all his sons. So it's up to you to sort out your life, because you have to give your own account to God. Do not seek the praises of men, but seek to glorify our Father by preaching gospel, drinking the blood of Christ. More you drink, stronger you will become, and then with authority you will preach gospel, as I'm demonstrating now. Our Father, bless you.